So now that we understand what a chiral center is, and we know how to recognize them on molecules, it's important that we know how to name them. So if you remember back to when I first taught you guys about just simple alkane nomenclature, we talked about the IUPAC naming system. And what I told you was that according to IUPAC protocol, every single molecule in the universe needs to get its own unique name. That's kind of the point of IUPAC, that now we have a systematic way to name every single molecule. Well, now that we've learned about stereoisomers, meaning molecules that possess chiral centers, that means that those stereoisomers, since they have different shapes, they're going to need to be included in the system somehow because they have a distinctive difference. Well, it turns out that all we have to do is we're going to use the same IUPAC names from before, but we're going to add just one extra step to account for those chiral centers. And that extra step is called the Kahn-Ingold prelog nomenclature. I know that name blows. So what we're going to be doing is we're not going to be using that name so much. That's kind of the technical name that's in your book. I like to just call it the R and S naming system. Okay? You'll understand why it's called R and S in a second. But for right now, just kind of take my word for it that you don't need to say Kahn-Ingold prelog in class. You could just say R and S and everyone will know what you're talking about. So in order to learn this one extra step, it's actually kind of a five-step process. So what we'll be doing is I'll be teaching you one step at a time with a molecule so that you can apply it and see exactly how to use that rule, okay? So let's go ahead and get started with our first step.